fingers. Play as you want, how you feel better. You feel good, you can play with any finger, but just should be here easier.
Throat singing is very popular in Tuva, I think, and a lot of people knows Tuva as a throat singing country, throat singers country. And in Tuva we have a lot of different styles, techniques of throat singing. Also we have a lot of musical instruments to accompany, yeah, to accompany throat singing. And most of musical instruments were made for accompany throat singing. Even drum, shaman drum, shamans also they use, some shamans use throat singing, so they accompany with drum. I try a lot of different kinds of wood, even wood from all over the world. In California, I try ebony, zebra wood, budwak, rosewood, and few more. And I try also different kinds of skins. How to use it, how to clean up, and all the things. I had experience with Pakistan goat skins, Iranian camel skin, and with other snake skin, fish skin, and mostly local skins, local what? Goat skin, wild goat skin, cow skin, horse, reindeer, elk, and we here built I mean, we can build the music instruments by any kind of wood and local wood. I learned how to build instruments by myself. I broke lots of instruments and I made a lot of mistakes, and I look for the music instruments of other builders, you know, very famous builder, Aldar Tamdyn, all these old masters works.
So you learned just by imitating the works that you saw from
yes,
other masters?
Yes, by imitating, and I broke a lot of instruments. At the beginning, I have to see what is inside, you know. I take off skin, I try to glue it back, but it wasn't possible, and finally I have to change a skin. It's how I learn. I start change skins, you know, and put strings on. Yeah.
So you didn't go to a master and ask him for help, or?
No. I saw, at the beginning, I saw how Mungo building instruments. And he was, in those time, he just start to build instruments. And I saw how Mungo clean a skin, how he cut wood, and I start making same things. But okay, if I made mistake, I just remember, okay, next time I wouldn't make same mistake.
Yeah.
And like this, 12 years. I work on it. Two years ago, I got a team, a very good team.
And now you're teaching them?
Yes, I find guys who are very great stone carvers, craftsmen, and I teach them how to build music instruments, and how thin it should be, how thick, why it should be thin, you know, because the sound, and how they can make, how bigger in horse head should be, how smaller, and all these design things, and they are very good at it. That deficit, my right deficit, it was not that much music instrument builders. So, for example, 12 years ago, it was very difficult to make money from our music. I mean, in Tuva, it was very difficult to be musician. Only musician, and if you work for the government, it was very small money for it for a month, and I have to feed my family. So music instruments helped me a lot, and almost every month I made new one, I sell it, and it helped me survive in Kyzyl, because in those time I was in Chadana, and I moved here alone, and I tried to find job. Finally, I got a job at Tuvan Filarmoni, and same time at I work at Tuvan College, music college, and I teach. And I would instruments in the basement, and it's how I made extra money, and I bring my family to Kyzyl, and now we have our, you see, our own apartment, car, all these things help me a lot.
That's it.